Well, Coach Wilcox put us in some great schemes to let us go out there and rush the passer, and Coach Thompson really hounded us this week about rushing the passer and using our pass rush moves that we work every week in practice. So, you know, we went out there and just played our game, and it worked out for the best, fortunately.
Well, you kind of, you know, four turnovers tonight. You set the tone kind of with forced fumble. Mm-hmm. Just talk about, you know, coming out, getting a hot start, energizing the defense.
Yeah, we watched film and we saw that when the quarterback runs the ball, he runs with a little loose. So I just went out there and tried to make the play, got it out. Wish I would have picked it up. That would have been nice, you know, but we got it, and we're just having fun. You know, we kind of started from there and just kept it going with AJ getting his pick and everything. And it was a real fun night, a great senior night to end my last game on.
Can you walk us through how to learn about last play, kind of what you saw, what your memories of were, and then after the play and all that, and also did you hear
Well, as the play was going on, the ball went like right over my head, and so I saw EG catch it. Then I tried to run with him. I tried to run with him as fast as I could, but he was fast. So I ended up doing the Lambo leap in the stands, and then they called. They said there was a flag and everything, and then we won. So I did it again in the student section. So it was a fun, fun.
So two different spots.
Like two different spots, yeah.
But you didn't. What was going through your head when you thought that the game went over, and then that would have been the third time after?
Well, I was hoping Tyler Bray would finish it. You know, I was kind of tired, and you know, they were that close. I was hoping they can capitalize and get a field goal or something. But you know, it was a good day for us, and I'm really happy.
Beating Tennessee is always a huge thing for Vanderbilt. When Tennessee beats Vanderbilt, I mean, is it any extra special because of the in-state connection, or
I mean,
happens so often you don't really get that worked up about it?
No, it is really important to us. You know, first of all, it's our first one in the SEC, which is a big plus for us. You know, in their in-state rivalry, you know, they had a great year this year. You know, they thought they were going to come in here and beat us on our home turf in our backyard, but we worked really hard, and we beat them. You know, it's a great win for us. We're all happy. We're all going to have fun. But at the end of the day, we just got to go back to work tomorrow and try to get a win against Kentucky.
Okay. Tyler Bray is also joining us right here.
Tyler, I guess all the guys have talked about, there's a different sense in practice and in the game today with you. I mean, could you tell throughout the weekend and today that, you've been around the team the whole time. Could you tell there's a different kind of level or more juice around them?
I mean, lose my voice. But, yeah, guys were seemed dead the last couple of weeks. I mean, it's not just me. We got two games left. Got to win both, and we won one tonight. Got one more to get to a bowl game.
It probably wasn't your best game of your career. I mean, but can you just kind of talk about battling through and the adversity that you guys had and finally getting one?
It was horrible. I mean, I think I completed more passes to the other team than I did to ours. But I mean, our team stuck in there. Defense played one hell of a game. I mean, they've been doing that for the last couple weeks. And so if they just keep playing like that and the offense steps it up, we're going to win a lot of ball games.
Who's up? Who's next?
Hey, Tyler. What happened with the gloves? Get mad at the pick? That was the gloves' fault? What
it's never the gloves' fault. I mean, I'm throwing it. The glove's not throwing it. But didn't feel like I was as accurate without them. And just said, kind of screw it. Let's just go out there and see what I can do without it. And seemed to work halfway decent.
The end of regulation. Can you take us through the sucker right flag? What that is?
Yeah, we do have a play called sucker and soccer, and Coach Henshaw was all jacked up and yelling, and I really didn't understand what he said, and so I went in there and just called something. And I was like, torn, just check it down. I was like, block for a little bit and just check down. I'm going to throw it to you and we'll get out of this quarter. Because I had no idea what we were running.
As the ball left your hand toward Derek, I mean, what was your thinking? Did you think, hey, we got a pretty good shot at this? Or did you think, I'm a little off the mark here?
On which one? The touchdown?
Yeah.
Oh, I knew he was going to get it. I mean, he's a big-time receiver going against a big-time corner, and he's got to make the play. I mean, we always got to win contested balls.
What's up?
On the interception, what happened when they penalized you? What was going on there?
Oh, the first guy came and tried to hit me, and the second guy came and I was like, oh no, I'll take the penalty. And I just took his knee out. I mean, they already scored. It doesn't really matter.
Hold on.
Was any of the mistakes, Tyler, on the thumb hurting, or is it just mental errors that could?
I was just throwing it to the other team.
Was that Russ, you think, or just?
I mean, you could blame it on the Russ. It's not though. It's just me just throwing to the other team. I mean, just making mistakes.
Anybody else? All right. Thank you, guys.